Right now on 13 on Your Side, breaking news, the FDA gives the okay, granting Pfizer emergency use authorization for the COVID-19 vaccine. So what comes next? We've got the very latest. Plus, amid the pandemic, a new trend gaining popularity across the country, an increasing amount of women freezing their eggs. We speak to a specialist about the anti-baby boom.
And wet and wintry weather has already moved into West Michigan. We'll show you what the potential impacts will be coming up.
Good evening, I'm Kirk Montgomery. 13 on Your Side Late Night starts right now.
You're watching 13 on Your Side.
Good evening. Thank you so much for joining us. Breaking news into the Information Center tonight. Within the hour, the FDA has given Pfizer the official green light for emergency use of their COVID-19 vaccine. But there is still one hurdle left. We will have more on that in just a moment. But first, we want to check in with Chief Meteorologist George Lessons, who is monitoring some very wet weather heading into our weekend. And depending on where you are, you're seeing some snow or a lot of rain.
A lot of rain here in the Grand Rapids metropolitan area. And
all right, thank you so much, George. Now to the topic on everyone's minds tonight, the COVID-19 vaccine. The FDA has given an emergency approval for Pfizer to start the vaccine rollout. It now goes to the CDC for final approval, and not a moment too soon. It was almost 1 year ago, January 21st, when the very first known case of the then deadly mystery virus was confirmed in a man in his 30s near Seattle. Today, one American is dying every 30 seconds from the virus. ABC's Marcy Gonzalez has the very latest. There is cautious optimism as numbers continue a slight downward trend in our state. Today, the state reported just over 5,100 new cases of COVID-19. The total in the state sits just above 426,000. 61 deaths were also reported today. The total deaths in Michigan have now reached 10,456. Grand Rapids Public Schools is the latest to announce it will go virtual through the new year. GRPS will move pre-K through 8th grade students to virtual learning through January 19th. High school students will remain virtual until otherwise advised by state or county health departments, although that date is subject to change. GRPS said they hope this is the last time they have to face this type of delay. And it is a trend that is emerging all across the country, a spike in the number of women interested in freezing their eggs amid the pandemic. 13 on Your Side's Sarah Makuta talked to two reproductive specialists about the freezing process and to find out if freezing your eggs is a guarantee to having a family in the future. In Muskegon County this morning, health leaders provided an update on their fight against COVID-19, and the Chamber of Commerce kicked off an effort to recognize the hard work of nurses and other frontline workers. 13 on Your Side's Lakeshore reporter John Mills has that part of our team coverage.
The Muskegon.
Happening right now at 11, a Christmas bombing in the streets of Nashville tonight. Hear about the 15-minute warning that likely saved lives. A Christmas morning fire in the city of Detroit. A family of six lived inside, but only four managed to get out alive. And the Washington waiting game. Will the president sign the stimulus bill, or will Congress have to come up with Plan B? Good evening, I'm Kirk Montgomery. 13 on Your Side Late Night starts right now.
You're watching 13 on Your Side.
Tonight, state, local, and federal investigators in Nashville, Tennessee are trying to find out who this RV belonged to. It blew up early this morning, causing extensive damage in the downtown entertainment district. Authorities believe the explosion was set off intentionally, but at this time, there is no known motive. And tonight, we are learning police have found what they believe are human remains near that explosion. ABC's Avery Harper brings us up to date. Switching to weather now, we want to show you a live look at downtown Grand Rapids. Pretty quiet compared to how things were just 24 hours ago. We want to get an update now from Michael Behrens. And Michael, again, looking festive, my friend, looking great. I got to tell you, my drive to work from the lakeshore today was much different than my drive home to the lakeshore yesterday.
Oh, yeah, we had that.
I'm Kirk Montgomery. 13 on Your Side at noon starts right now.
You're watching 13 on Your Side at noon.
Good afternoon. We begin this noon with a developing story out of Lansing. Within the last 90 minutes, Governor Gretchen Whitmer has activated the National Guard because of the potential for violence at the state capitol this weekend. We want to get right to our Elena Holland, who is joining us live. She has been monitoring multiple briefings this morning with police agencies on their plans to protect the capitol. Elena, what have you learned? Okay, we're going to take a break from the news of the day just for a moment and talk about the weather. Let's take a look at what's happening from our Walker Tower cam. And yeah, what is that? Looks like we've got some snow flurries. We've got some maybe some rain all happening at the same time. Let's call it a wintry mix. I know that that's what our Michael Behrens might call it. Hey, Michael, how are you? It's a wintry mix, isn't it?
Merry Christmas. There's some more in there for you.
Some feel compelled to offer Daniel more than money. Yeah. Daniel may be a tad out of tune.
No matter what his physical disabilities are,